I think that's for me, because I came up with the idea. And I came across the story over 10 years ago. And it's actually a very funny story. I don't know if you want me to go into it, but yeah, I will, what the heck. when Laurie and I were first married, I'm going back 35 years, we've been married for 35 years now. When we first got married, we went back to England, which is where I was from originally. I have to also add that I was born in England. I was originally a Brit, but I have lived most of my life in the Philippines. So, talaga, I'm really Pinoy. I'm puti lang, but Pinoy. At heart. And we got married, and we went back to England to see my family. And we went to a wedding, and I'm Jewish, and it was a Jewish wedding. And halfway through the wedding, as in every wedding, they start singing Rabbana Gila. And Laurie started singing along with it. And how do you know Rabbana Gila?
What was the song again?
Rabbana Gila. It's a Hebrew song.
Ah, okay.
Rabbana Gila, Rabbana Gila.
And they start dancing with the legs.
How do you know Rabbana Gila?
I see movies. Yeah.
But anyway, so that was my question to her. And she was saying, well, we used to sing this as kids in the street. And I said, it's a Hebrew song. And she said, no, it's a dialect. I said, no, I think you'll find it's a Hebrew song. So when we got back to the Philippines, I also have to add, I'm a terrible Jew. Because I never go to synagogue. And I go to church much more often than I go to synagogue. But so we went to the synagogue for me to find out. And I went with a friend. And I asked him, do you know why my wife knows how to sing Rabbana Gila and why they were singing it in the streets when she was growing up? And he explained the whole story. Ah, yeah, there's a very good reason. And if you go into the synagogue, they have a whole room at the back about the history of Jews in the Philippines. And it was so interesting. And the story about Quezon, because I didn't know it, the story about Quezon saving the Jews from Germany was mind-boggling. But all of the Jewish community in the Philippines knew it. What I found out, I then started researching because I thought, this is way back, 10 or so years ago, this would make a great movie. So when I started researching it, what I found out was that it wasn't commonly known by Filipinos. And I thought, you know, this is a story that needs to be told. It needs to be told because it was a remarkable feat of humanity that has been lost. And I need to bring it back so that people know about it. And that was really the start of the development of the movie. I would also like to say thank you. I'd just like to point out that this movie is a thank you from me to the Philippines.
Aww.
And it is that, hang on, wait, because I'm gonna tell you why. I'm gonna bore you now. It is that because I am a Jew, and growing up in England, which is one of the safest places to be as a Jew, I experienced prejudice. I experienced prejudice as a child, and bigotry, and it was just part of life for a Jew. And when I arrived in the Philippines 37 years ago, to this day, I have never, ever come across bigotry or prejudice or dislike or distrust because I am white or because I am Jewish. And that's why I felt I needed to make this movie to tell the world that there is a people where you don't experience this, and I haven't experienced it anywhere in the world. So it's a thank you really from me.
Wow.
for taking me in over these 37 years. So thank you.